Hi, everyone. Meteorologist Griffin Hardy in for Chief Meteorologist Chris Justice tonight. And the weather's already turning messy out there. The rain has already started to arrive in the upstate. It's going to stay steady with the rain, and it's going to stay cold for most of the night tonight. We'll see it turn heavy tomorrow morning, especially heavy during the morning commute. So this is really when the impact portion of our forecast begins and will continue into tomorrow morning. And thankfully, it'll start to clear out by tomorrow afternoon. But here's what we're talking about with the impact weather. Heavy rain tonight with some brief gusty winds possible. Again, it continues all night tonight and most of tomorrow morning. We're still looking at around 1.5 to 2.5 inches of rain possible in total. That will definitely cause some slick roadways. It's already starting to do so now, of course, but especially tomorrow morning from 4 a.m. to 8 a.m. is when the rain should be at its heaviest. Here's a live look at that Hilton Greenville sky cam. Very low cloud bases already. Lots of rain out there, and temperatures are cold, very cold, but not quite cold enough for freezing rain or sleet. It looks like it's just going to stay liquid rain for this storm system that's sweeping through, sitting at 42 degrees in Greenville this afternoon, in Greenville and Anderson, 42 in Asheville as well, sitting at 39 over in Spartanburg. All this happening thanks to an upper level system, which is actually centered over the upper Midwest and pulling a lot of moisture from the Gulf of Mexico into the deep south. And the weather itself is not great, of course, for us, but it's a little bit more serious down towards Louisiana and Mississippi, with a lot of severe weather happening in this part of the world today. Many active tornado warnings across parts of Louisiana and Mississippi and even West Alabama now this afternoon. Thankfully, the severe weather threat stays down to the south for today and tonight. It's a very high risk of severe weather in that general area where we're seeing those tornado warnings develop. And you see it stretches all the way up into Alabama and Georgia, where there is a low end threat for severe weather. But the good news for us is the wedge, you know, that wedge of cold air we often see in this part of the world is going to work in our favor. Those northeast winds are going to keep dew points down and temperatures down, so we're really just not going to see the humidity we need for any severe weather. It's just going to remain a cold, steady rain as we're seeing right now on satellite radar across the upstate. So let's take you through the hour by hour forecast. Again, rest of the night tonight, rain will stay steady. There are some pockets of heavier rain showing up at 9 p.m. into tomorrow morning, 1 a.m. We've got some heavier downpours that may keep you up tonight with some brief rumbles of thunder, but thankfully, that is still not going to be anything severe, I don't think. Then 4 a.m. rolls in, rain all over the place. We get later into the morning, 6, 7 a.m., still some heavy downpours there. This is when the morning rush starts, so definitely give yourself plenty of extra time in the morning and drive extra caution on your way to work or school early in the morning. By 9 a.m., we're kind of on the backside of it, and we see the showers kind of gradually dissipate. By lunchtime, the rain stops, and late into the mid-afternoon, we start to get some clearing sky back to the west. Sky should clear out for the vast majority of us into Thursday evening. Then by Thursday night, the main story is just going to be the cold temperatures on the way. I think most places in western North Carolina are probably going to hit the freezing mark early Friday morning, and we'll be close to that freezing mark, 32 for Friday morning across the upstate. Rainfall potential still pretty much on target, around 1.5 to 2 inches across the area, with some locally higher amounts, up to 2.5 inches possible there. Not really enough to be a huge flood threat, but it is definitely good soaking of rain for us. So here's what we have for the 4-day. Morning rain tomorrow, p.m. sunshine. We've got the sunshine, of course, returning in the afternoon. It stays with us for Friday, and it stays cold for the rest of the weekend. We've got highs only in the 40s Saturday, Sunday. Lows will drop below freezing in the upstate starting Sunday morning and continuing into next week. Winter officially begins next Wednesday. That's when the solstice happens, even though it already very much feels like it, with highs only in the 40s and 50s. Western North Carolina, same story, even colder, though, dropping below freezing Friday morning, staying below freezing with those lows Saturday, Sunday, all the way into next week.